She was the Fifth Element's most enigmatic and captivating character, a performer who enraptured her audiences and left Corbin Dallas speechless. But who was the mysterious woman that brought the diva to life? She has never before granted an interview about the Fifth Element. But today, in Paris, France, we meet the actress named simply Mai Wen. And she will speak for the very first time about the magnificent diva.
The first time I heard about the diva was in my bed. My fiancé was Luc Besson at this time. And we were just becoming together for a few months, and he started talking about the diva character. He said, maybe I want you to do it. And I said, oh, thank you, but if I love you, I want to show you my love that is pure, so I don't want to work with you. Either you choose you are with me and we don't work together, either we're not together and okay, I would do the diva. And he said, I think I prefer to be with you. He was always showing me the test for Lilou, for the diva, for Gary Oldman. And one day he showed me the test of the diva and he found a very nice girl. She was a top model, a German top model, blonde. I don't remember her name. And he was really, really happy to do it with her. So I said, you see, I didn't do it and you're happy to find the girl, so there's no problem. He said, yeah, yeah, very happy. And 2 days before the preparation of her costume, you know, she was supposed to come in London to do the costume, the test for the makeup, everything. She disappeared. No news from her, from her agent, nothing. And we were on weekend, and he was so stressed on the phone. Where is she? And I told him, oh, come on. Anyway, if she doesn't show up in 2 days, I would do it. But I didn't thought it. So he said, oh, you would do it? Oh, you know what? I think, in fact, I want you to do it. So I said, but she's gonna show up, don't worry. And then Monday, she never show up. And I said, okay, okay, I'm doing it. It was the movie of the man I loved, so I was really, really happy, even if I was not supposed to act it. Yeah. The most challenging part was learning how to sing. It was very complex, how to breathe, how to sing. Very difficult. I was listening to the sing like 30 times a day. It has to be each second perfect. Even if they put the voice of a professional singer, I had to be really, we had to believe it's me. Even if I had the playback, I was supposed to sing. Luc wanted me to sing. I had 3 months preparation before shooting, which is good. It's not too short, not too long, just perfect. So the process of the makeup was starting with the makeup, the face. They put the makeup there, there like that, and then the hat was glued on my head. Then the stilts, and then the dress. I think the end is the dress, because it's very fragile. And they were giving me food with pie.
strong.
I was so tall, so the crew couldn't be with me anyway. I had to be with my own crew, because they knew what could I eat, what could I drink. They knew my head was so heavy. I had a special chair to sit. It was very tiring. 3 hours to make everything up. Makeup, dress, everything. 3 hours preparation every day. I think I needed to have this challenge. It was like, this day I'm gonna have the concert. So it was true. We didn't do it in a different place with studio, with actors. It was real. Luc Besson likes very much to impress the actors. He likes the spontaneity. So no one of the actors saw me before shooting. It was keeping secret. So Bruce Willis didn't see me before shooting on the scene of the concert. I was hiding behind the curtains in London for the concert, and Luc, before shooting, said, "Ladies and gentlemen, tonight you're gonna see a special singer. She's a bit strange, and I want you to be just natural. You just let your feelings go away." And then the curtain opens, the music starts, and I could feel in the theater how people were so impressed, and Bruce Willis was, "Oh, my God!" Such a big changing. Each actor has to do his private dreams about the character. I felt she was sad about the human being. She was disappointed. Mm-hmm. Disappointed. She was giving the love. Maybe because she didn't have for her. I don't know. But I felt like a sad character. The blue was, I don't know, it means a lot for me. Tell you something very personal. I gave so many times, so many energy to this character that when I discovered the movie with the scene that he chose, I was a bit disappointed because it goes too fast. You know, when he did the editing, when I was singing, and there's Lilou and some people fighting. And I was shocked he didn't show more of the concert, because for me it was magical. So when I saw the movie, I thought, oh, the people are not gonna see me. They are not gonna see my work. Maybe they don't know how much time I spent for the character. Then I saw on internet so many sites about the diva.
That's so strange,
because the movie doesn't give any attention of the character. That's why I was so impressed when he asked me to do an interview about my character.
I was like, ooh.
Mai Wen was disappointed that nobody could experience the diva's entire performance. But this never-before-seen green screen footage reveals for the first time the complete diva performance. It was filmed at Pinewood Studios in London during principal photography.